awful.
And even though they chose the one,
Jared Chef,
it was clear to Chef Ramsay that two of his final five,
Jared, give me your jacket, please,
didn't measure up.
Manda, take off your jacket, please.
Ending both of their chances of becoming the next head chef at BLT Steak at Bally's in Las Vegas. And now, the continuation of Hell's Kitchen.
Get out of here.
Yeah, chef. Get out of here, chef. That's crazy. Are you okay? I'm in complete and utter shock. I've never seen him sit in two black jackets home at the same time ever. You know, it's a little sad. Jared was my best friend here. He was always there for me when I needed him, but I have to focus on winning without him. You're the final three.
We're the final three.
Yo, can someone pinch me? I'm excited, but I'm not gonna be celebrating and asking for champagne until I win the competition.
You okay?
I don't know what to do right now. I don't know what to do with my hands.
Look at me now. I'm stronger, I'm better, and I'm that much closer to being the head chef at BLT. There's no taking me down.
Tomorrow at this time, there will be two of us.
So bad.
I know.
It sucks because Ariel's a monster, so it's going to be difficult to get her out.
I know. I've been thinking about it. I'm like, I don't... Like, trying to find weaknesses.
It's difficult because you have three strong women right now. Ariel thinks she's strong, I think I'm strong, and Ashley thinks she's strong. So it's going to take an army to take down any of us. You're literally just gonna have to trip the girl behind you as she walks out the door.
I just feel like Ariel's attitude might f*** her up. I really do.
I mean, I think that has to be a factor.
Honestly, it really does.
After a night of strategizing, Kristen and Ashley...
Let's go, ladies. Line up.
...and Ariel have been told to meet Chef Ramsay outside to hear about their next assignment.
Right, good morning.
Good morning, Chef.
This motorcade has traveled 5 hours from Las Vegas to bring this very special delivery to Hell's Kitchen.
What the is going on?
Sir, if you wouldn't mind, please open the doors. Thank you. Wow, oh boy. Are you ready to find out what's inside the briefcases?
Yes, sir. My first thought is it money?
Sir, could you please open briefcase number one?
I knew it.
Oh,
I knew it. I did not think it was going to be money.
In there is actually $250,000. And for one of you, that money will be yours. Ariel, what's going through your mind?
My sibling's college education is going through my mind.
Interesting. Ashley?
A house for my mom, Chef.
A house for your mom. Nice. Love that. Kristen?
A lot of hard work, Chef.
A lot of hard work. Good. Right now, I'd like you all to choose a briefcase. Ariel, what number would you like?
I don't know, Chef.
Number one.
That's all I want right now. Three, Chef.
Number three. Ashley.
Number four, Chef.
Number four. And Kristen, that leaves you with number two. Now that everyone has a briefcase, are you ready to see what's inside?
Yes, Chef.
Gentlemen, please open the briefcases.
Yes. I'm so happy right now. I have this gorgeous, thick ribeye with all that fatty on it, like just fatty goodness.
We have some very exquisite bone-in cuts that were literally transported from BLT Steak at Bally's Las Vegas.
Wow.
And if you become the next head chef, you should be in a position to excel with each and every one of these amazing cuts. This is an opportunity to prove that you're the one for the job.
Yes, Chef.
For today's challenge, you've all got 40 minutes to make an amazing steak dish and two stunning sides. Hold on a second. Whoa. I think I better grab this one. You have 40 minutes and your time starts now. Let's go.
In today's BLT Bone-In Steak Challenge, the final three will have 40 minutes to perfectly cook their cut of beef.
What'd you get?
Filet.
Ribeye, Chef.
It's a big cut. The winner goes to a steakhouse, so you should be menu-minded.
I've never in my life cooked a filet that big. I've never in my life cooked a filet with a bone in it, so this is going to be a challenge for you.
Sear on this guy.
I love Southwestern food, so that's my immediate plan. I'm doing a twice-baked potato stuffed pasilla pepper, and then a chipotle butter with the beans and the corn.
Hey guys, I didn't go Asian today. Aren't you proud of me?
25 minutes to go.
The chef. Sure, Chef.
Where are you headed with yours, Ariel?
Chef, I am going to grill my New York strip. I have a few different sides going, so
yeah, you got a bunch going on.
I'm gonna try to get them, see whatever gets done first, whatever tastes best. I don't know what I'm gonna make until everything's on the plate, and cooking a steak is pretty straightforward, so my main focus is pretty much on the sides. I'm gonna do a bacon and onion vinaigrette with the steak.
Last 10 minutes.
Yes, Chef. Bye, Chef.
This is a steak challenge. We're fighting for a steakhouse. This has to be perfect.
Careful with walking around with your steak in your hand.
Right.
Drop that on the floor, then what? Right?
Game over, Chef.
Yep.
A ribeye tastes so good with all that fatty on it. So first thing that comes to mind is keeping it simple and classic. Blue cheese, salt and pepper.
Mind you hot?
I really wanted the steak to shine on its own and have the sides be complimentary.
30 seconds to go. Come on. Let's go. 10.
Oh, no.
9. 8. 7. 6. 5. 4. 3. 2. 1. And stop. Good job. Well done. Chefs, are you confident in your dishes?
Yes, Chef.
Glad to hear it, because I have a very special guest judge. Now, this man knows a thing or two about steak, let me tell you. He's now the executive chef of Wolfgang Puck's Michelin-starred steakhouse, Cut, in Beverly Hills. Please welcome Chef Ari Rosenson. Chef, welcome.
Chef, how are you?
Good to see you.
Chef Ari is a really great chef. He knows exactly what a steakhouse steak is supposed to look like and what it's supposed to taste like. So this is not going to be easy.
Ashley, Ariel, Kristen, bring all three steaks forward. Thank you. Good. Thank you.
Honey.
Good job.
As I'm seeing the other girls' dishes in front, I'm like, wow, they have a lot more going on than I do. But I think my plate says steakhouse all over it.
Lucia, how does that look?
They look very different. Although there's steak on a plate, technically, they're all presented with a unique vision in mind.
Mm-hmm. Interesting. Let's begin with Ashley. And please describe your dish to Chef.
What I did for you today is a Southwestern style filet. I rubbed it with pasilla pepper and smoked chili powder. And the side that I have for you is a grilled poblano pepper. And the veg that I have is all sauteed in chipotle butter. So the all three components combine really well. My dish looks sexy. Just like me, so I know that I am ready to go.
You definitely left the steak in the foreground. Let it speak for itself, which cooking is what a steak is all about.
Thank you.
The pepper is a little bit undercooked.
Okay.
It definitely needs to, like, maybe cook with the steak and baste it a little bit or braise it even.
Great effort. Perfectly cooked in the middle.
Thank you, Chef.
Good. What a great start. Ariel, please describe your dish to Chef.
Chef, I'll start with the steak. I did a roasted garlic and poblano pepper butter for the corn. So some of the oil that was left over from the garlic, I poured over the steak to kind of baste it. I also put some of the butter on the steak and some grilled pineapple. And then the other side is spaghetti squash with a cipollini onion and bacon vinaigrette with some fennel as well.
Wow.
Good flavor. Beautifully seasoned.
The temperature on the protein is spot on.
Absolutely.
The squash is delicious.
There's a lot going on there.
There is a lot in that little dish, but I want it to have a lot of flavor.
Overall, yeah. Well executed.
Strong effort.
Thank you, Chef.
Kristen, please describe your dish to Chef.
I have a bacon and gorgonzola potato puree. And I have a grilled asparagus, just seasoned with salt and pepper, a little bit of garlic shallot, and my ribeye with a red wine demi, grilled and finished in a cast iron for a little bit more char.
Beautifully cooked.
Wow, delicious.
This has got to be a good thing. Like, he's drooling over my ribeye right now.
Definitely caramelization on both sides, flavor through and through. It's very difficult to nail potatoes. That's why it's a sign of a good chef is a great potato dish.
Now, Chef Ari, I mean, these three reiterate to me that we have definitely got the three most talented chefs in this competition.
Yeah,
I mean,
absolutely.
Three good efforts.
Yeah.
Now for the hard part. Ari, which dish would you prefer?
All Kristen did was typical steakhouse, potatoes and veg. I thought outside the box and I did something completely different. Got it.
It's a difficult decision.
That's why you're here.
I have faith in my dish. It tastes good and it's the most outstanding compared to everyone else.
Ladies, we're struggling. This is down to the tiny detail because you've nailed the protein. Let's get that right.
I'm so nervous. I'm hoping my sides complement it as well as I think they do.
Is it Ashley's bone-in filet, Ariel's New York strip, or Kristen's ribeye?
For my flavor profile, the way I like to eat a steak, I would have to say.
In today's bone-in steak challenge, Chef Ramsay had brought in cuts of meat from BLT, the prize restaurant. Now it's time for guest judge Ari Rosenson to announce the winner of today's challenge.
Ari, which dish would you prefer?
For my flavor profile, the way I like to eat a steak, I would have to say Kristen's ribeye.
Wow.
Thank you, chef.
Well done. Well done.
Oh my god, like, I'm elated. I'm on cloud nine right now. I kept my dish simple and it came out ahead.
Join me in thanking Chef Ari. Chef, as always.
Thank you, Chef.
Thank you, Chef.
Thank you, Chef.
Good luck to you.
Thank you so much.
See you shortly. Take care.
I think that Kristen stayed super simple, super safe. I think I should have won.
Kristen.
Yes, Chef.
I have a fantastic reward for you today. You just cooked for Ari. Now, it's his turn to cook for you. A cut in Beverly Hills.
That's amazing.
A reward like this shouldn't be experienced alone, right?
Agreed.
I'll be joining you.
Yay!
Get changed. My car is waiting. Let's go.
All right. See
Good
you
job.
Soon. Yes! I'm so happy right now. This is the greatest feeling.
Two very good dishes. You three are neck and neck. Good job. Don't be despondent. However, whilst Kristen and I are dining at the cut, you'll be scrubbing down that armored truck. As you know, it went through a 5-hour journey across that desert to get here. Give her a little wipe down to those police motorcycles as well. After that, I want both you to prep the kitchen ahead of tonight's service. Now get out of here.
Chef. Damn, I really wanted to win that challenge. So now Kristen has a leg up because she gets to be on the reward with Chef Ramsay and pick his mind. So I'm just really over this punishment before it even starts. Really, Chef? Really, Chef? Really?
God, I want to have lunch with Chef Ramsay. It sucks. He's only been my idol since I was 5 years old.
Oh, ladies are busy. Ladies, please be careful there. Some sharp objects. No more injuries, please. Welcome.
Nice car, Chef.
Thank you, Aaron. Just trying to start. Not for you.
Chef would have way more fun at lunch with me than Kristen.
Bye, ladies.
Bye. Chef Ramsay looks so handsome in his suit.
Damn, that's one good-looking white man.
Wow, how nice is this?
This is amazing. What was the hardest thing for you when you were my age?
27, 28 was the turning point for me, because that's when I knew that I had to get my together.
I know that feeling.
It was just right, no matter what happens. It's gonna be in this industry.
27, it's the turning point in my life as well. Before that, I was rebellious. I did everything and anything I could to defy my parents. But now I come into the kitchen every day with a mission to cook my heart out. It's been a long time coming, but it's a good thing.
The final three?
Yeah.
Incredible.
Incredible is not even a word.
So the whole restaurant is just for you.
Oh my god.
Oh, I think there's two other guests.
Oh my god. Mom!
Good to see you all.
It couldn't be a better time to see my parents.
You have an amazing daughter.
Yes, we do.
Enjoy. I'll see you back at Hell's Kitchen.
Thank you so much, Chef Ramsay. This was the best gift that you could have given me.
Oh my god.
So I totally kicked ass in the challenge today. It was a steak challenge.
That's really cool. Has there been anything that you've had an issue with?
Oh my god. I got in a fight with a girl one night.
Will you get the out of my
hands on me.
Dad, put your hands on me.
Out of my face. But I walked away.
Good girl.
All the faith you guys have had in me has been my savior at the end of the day.
We have a pretty strong, loving family that's going to back anything and everything that you do.
Well, that's what it's always been, you know?
Yeah. My parents have been by my side through all of my ups and downs. I've dealt with a lot of heartbreak, a lot of disappointment. The thing that keeps you going is, you know, parents like mine.
You need to go in and kick some ass. If you want it, you gotta take it.
Oh, that feisty mom. You get,
that's
I knew I needed to see you for a reason.
That's right. I'm just kidding. Tear up. So cool.
Coming up.
I need you to cut these Wellingtons in a way I can stand them up.
Rice undercooked, Ariel. I need this back on, please. Ashley, how long?
No answer.
If you don't think that you're going to win, then you shouldn't be here.
The person advanced to the final is...
After a much-appreciated reward with her parents in Beverly Hills.
What's up, guys?
Hey.
Yeah.
Kristen rejoins Ariel and Ashley to prep for tonight's very important dinner service.
I just wish I would've got to talk to Chef.
Well, you know,
it was a really cool reward.
Did you have fun?
Yeah, I got to see both my parents.
Oh, nice.
What happened? I had to see both my parents. For real? Yeah. They were at the Wilshire.
I was definitely envious of the fact that she got to have that one-on-one with Chef Ramsay. But then she says, I got to see both my parents. And I was like, yeah, you could have saved that news, bitch.
I would have loved to see my parents.
That is some right there, bro. That's crazy.
Ladies, let's go. Line up Blue Kitchen, please. Quick, let's go. Line up. Tonight is the service that will determine who will enter the Hell's Kitchen final. Tonight is not just about how you perform behind the line. It's how you perform as a leader. Because each one of you will have a turn at the hot plate, running Hell's Kitchen. There should be constant communication, a great rhythm at all times. So, it is absolutely important when you're up at the pass to take control. What are you gonna do?
Take control, Chef.
Can't hear you.
Take control, Chef.
Ladies, get on your station. Good luck. Let's go. Mourinho.
See you, Chef.
Open Hell's Kitchen, please.
Move it up.
Let's go.
Tonight, each chef will be tested by running the pass.
Definitely ready for this. Yeah, buddy.
Providing them the opportunity to showcase for Chef Ramsay their leadership skills and quality control.
Good luck to all three of you.
While they're working the pass, sous chefs Christina and Aaron will be covering their stations.
4 covers table 32, 2 risotto di carbonara.
Yes, Chef! Pasta's drunk.
Tonight's dinner service is gonna be epic. I'm already feeling like a sense of honor just to be in the top 3, but going in the top 2, I'm just more motivated. I can taste it.
First risotto coming to the pass. Waffle with your lobster tail. Carbonara coming to the pass.
Very nice, that carbonara, on point.
Thanks, Chef.
with appetizers flying out quickly into the dining room.
Ariel!
Yes, Chef?
To the hot plate, please. Let's go.
Yes, Chef.
Ariel is up first to run the pass.
More importantly, show me and them who's the boss. Yes, okay? Chef. Here we go.
One tip, four covers, appetizers, two risotto, two scallops.
Yes, Chef. Yes, Chef.
Risotto, how long?
Got about 2 minutes, Chef.
2 minutes, heard.
Out of the three people here, I definitely think that I have a really strong chance of being the winner of Hell's Kitchen, but never know what's gonna happen.
I'm waiting on two risotto and two scallops, so how long for that risotto?
2 minutes.
The risotto that you're working right now, Chef, how long?
2 minutes.
That's what I said. Okay.
2 minutes, Ash.
This is the fourth time you told me 2 minutes. All right, I need you to hurry that up.
Okay.
Chef Christina, can I have those two risotto, please?
Yep, in my hand.
Chef Ramsay will be using sous chefs Christina and Aaron to help test the chef's quality control and attention to detail.
Walking with lobster tail.
Yep, good. Let's go.
Thank you.
I really need that risotto.
Yes, Chef.
You can put it in my hand. I'll walk it to the pass.
Ariel's first test is already in her hands. A risotto made from carrot puree instead of squash.
Stop. Put it down. First of all, the color of that. Taste that.
I tasted it,
though. I want you to taste it again.
Okay.
You can argue all you want, but no. Taste it. Tell me, why is it so sweet?
I don't know, Chef. It tastes good. I don't know.
Carrot puree. It's not butter or squash. Yep. Maybe carrot puree. Yep.
Yes.
Look at me.
Yes.
You can put your head down and get pissed off, but it's carrot.
No, I'm not pissed off. It just tastes good.
Yeah.
I was just frustrated. I mean, I don't really watch Hell's Kitchen like Ashley, so I wasn't thinking that sabotage was going to happen.
See the color?
Yeah, Chef.
With me or not?
I'm with you all the way.
There you go. Check on everything, yeah?
All
right. So you know where you're going, yes?
After failing her first quality test, Ariel knows it's important that she proves her worthiness with the remainder of her time at the pass.
Four covers, two artichoke, two Wellington.
Yes, Chef.
Right now, I'm just anxious. I had no idea, like, what I was going to encounter, what I was going to go through. But I need to show Chef I'm better than this.
Chef, this char garnish isn't right. I need herbs in the char garnish. The potatoes aren't crispy.
Well spotted.
I've been through a lot in my 26 years, and I'm not giving up. Success is my only option. Failure is not.
Kristen, can you come up here to the pass, please? I need you to cut these Wellingtons in a way I can stand them up. It's not trimmed off enough.
Okay, I can do that.
Good. Well spotted.
This is my only opportunity, and I'm definitely very confident in myself.
Good, let's go. You know where you gotta go, quick. Good.
Despite her less than perfect start, Ariel is able to regain her composure and finish strong.
Ariel, good job. On the garnish, swap places with Aaron, please. Aaron, go to me, please.
We chef.
Kristen, to the hot plate, please. Let's go.
Chef. It really all comes down to this. At this point, if you don't think that you're going to win, then you shouldn't be here.
Order six guests, table 20, two snapper, two Wellington, two New York strip.
Yes, Chef.
Hurt.
Final two. Almost here. It's almost here. Whatever he's throwing at me today, I have to be the best that I can be.
I'm walking up on New York, and I'm walking up on Wellington, Chef. Wellington?
Thank you.
New York to your left.
I'll slice the New York strip. You look at me.
Yes, sir.
Mashed potato, asparagus, Wellington on there, yes?
Yes, sir.
Good girl.
Kristen's first challenge is to identify that one of the Wellingtons brought up by Chef Eric does not contain duck cell between the meat and puff pastry.
They look very different. This is not going to work.
There's no duck cell in it. Chef Eric, to the hot plate, please.
Yes, Chef. What's wrong, Chef?
There's no
duck cell
in this.
We have
another one.
You're fired right now.
Thank you, Chef.
Good. Well spotted.
Not only are you trying to get used to running the pass, but now you have a bunch of random. This is crazy.
Snapper? Ashley, to the hot plate. Snapper, it's burned. Really overcooked. Refire. Snapper, how long?
Gotta stay in control.
Yes, Chef.
Otherwise, they're gonna throw you under the bus.
Ashley, how long? Ashley?
No answer. She's not listening. Ashley.
Yes, Chef?
Look at me. You can't just screw her. I don't think that's too much to ask now, is it?
I don't know where Ashley's head is right now, but I feel like I need to, like, slap her out of it.
Ashley, you talking to me or should I talk to myself? At least answer me.
It's 45 minutes into dinner service.
No answer. She's not listening.
But Ashley's lack of communication.
Ashley, you can't just screw her. I don't think that's too much to ask now, is it?
Is creating a potential problem for Kristen, whose turn it is running the pass.
Ashley, you talking to me or should I talk to myself? At least answer me.
I don't know where Ashley's head is right now, but this is not gonna fly.
Ashley, snapper. Walk in with two snapper.
My apologies.
Here we go. Here, please. Let's go. You know where we're going, yes? Go, John. My apologies.
With Ashley's refire on the snapper passing inspection, Kristen's first entrees are now being delivered to the dining room.
Thank you,
I'm welcome. Kristen, I have another sticker for you.
Thank you.
There you go.
And Marino is about to test her attention to detail with an improperly written ticket.
Four guests, table 53, two risotto, one cappellini. We don't even have cappellini on the menu, so ignore that.
Hey, no, come here. No. First of all,
Chef.
You look at the ticket first. You read it, you study it. Cappellini went off the menu 6 weeks ago. Get him over here and tell him to rewrite the ticket.
My fault.
Marino!
Hey, because you can't stand there and look like that in front of the gate. Yeah, so address it.
Cappellini?
Yeah, sorry, Chef.
Sabotages are the worst. It's like being in Super Mario Brothers. You're just trying to jump over obstacles.
New order!
There's nowhere to hide, and you just have to deal with it.
My fault. Two risotto, two carbonara, followed with two Arctic char, two New York strip.
Two char, two strip.
Two char, two strip, her, Chef.
Are you going to give this to me both at the same time?
I am going to do my best, Chef.
I trust you, Chef.
Little hiccups are going to happen anytime you do something for the first time. But I just don't feel like anything can stop me.
I can still play risotto, yes, Chef?
Yeah, absolutely. Taste everything.
It's carrot.
Good. Well spotted.
Chef, two more risotto without carrots, please.
Heard, Chef. My apologies. 30 seconds on a perfectly seasoned refire risotto.
30 seconds, heard, Chef.
Chef Christina is sneaky. She really is.
Chef Christina, did you put cheese in this?
Oh, yeah, mascarpone emperor.
Mascarpone emperor?
Sneaky. Sneaky, sneaky.
Little salt in there, Chef?
It's in there.
Good. Well spotted.
Need a little bit more, Chef?
Sure.
Good. Love it.
Getting a little... Watch yourself.
Okay, give that to me. Good, let's go.
After a reasonably strong performance in the pass.
Okay, well done. Change the section, let's go.
It's time for Kristen to return to her station and make way for the final member of the trio, Ashley, to run the kitchen.
Ashley, you're with me on the hot plate?
I was struggling on fish for a minute, but this is my chance to redeem myself. You know, giving up is not in my vocabulary. I don't do that.
Your first table, yes?
All right. New order. Appetizer. Two risotto, two carbonara. Yes, Chef?
Yeah. Check everything, yes?
Yes, Chef.
And taste everything. Let's go.
How long on the risotto, Ariel?
No answer from Ariel. Gotta get organized, Ashley. Wakey, wakey, let's go. Gotta get going. Just gotta get going. Two risotto, two carbonara. How long?
3 minutes, Chef.
3 minutes.
Ashley says she's a strong leader, but, like, she's moving around and not doing anything.
Ashley, please. Let's go. We can't stare, but darling, we've got to get in there.
Right behind that, two carbonara, two risotto.
Thank you.
Taste it here.
It's good, chef.
Rice under cooked, back in there. Rice under cooked.
Oh my God, Ashley, you're so stupid.
Rice under cooked, Ariel, I need this back on, please.
She's not listening.
Ariel, come grab this risotto.
Take my scallop home and grab that when I come to the back.
No, I said the rice is undercooked. I think it needs more cooking, which is more important. Right, Ashley. Everybody on the hot plate has made mistakes.
Yes, chef.
Okay, you're down. You're not you, and you're quiet, and you're just unresponsive. What's the matter? Ashley. I want to see how you bounce back.
ShopFox.com for your copy of the Hell's Kitchen Cookbook. It's an hour and a half into the dinner service that will determine which two chefs move on to the finals.
You're down. You're not you, and you're quiet, and you're just unresponsive.
And Ashley's lack of confidence running the kitchen has Chef Ramsay concerned.
I need you to get your head out of the sand.
Yes, chef.
What's the matter? You have a chance to make a comeback.
I know.
But talk to me. I'm here to help you. I know how hard it is, but if you don't communicate with me, how can I help you? Don't give up. You with me? You're still in it?
Oh, yeah.
Come on, let's go.
I believe that Chef Ramsay sees something in me, and I'm not gonna go down without a fight. They're not just gonna get me out that easy, no way.
On your right-hand side, to risotto.
Risotto needs more salt.
Let's go, well spotted.
I need more truffle oil, more chives, more cheese on these fries. There's nothing there.
Oh, bland. Yes, good catch.
Woo!
Yes! This Pearl Blanc needs more salt and more lemon, chef.
Good, well spotted.
After some good quality control work.
Go, please.
New ticket in! Two scallops, two risotto, two carbonara.
Yes, chef!
Ashley's next test is coming from Chef Ramsay himself, who is replacing the black bean puree for the scallops with black garlic puree.
Chance some more spoons.
Wow, this looks like...
Talk to me.
This doesn't look right.
You're absolutely right. First of all, it's black garlic puree.
Okay.
And here, that's the bean puree. Well spotted. Good girl.
Hell yeah. Nothing's getting by me. So, you, Ariel and Kristen. I got that right.
Ashley's success with his planned sabotage impressed Chef Ramsay.
Entrees! Two char, two welly, two New York strip. How long?
About 60 seconds, chef.
But now, Chef Christina is replacing Arctic char in the entrees with deceptively similar-looking salmon.
There it is, crispy skin.
Two char, char, beurre blanc, please. Check the fish, please.
Two char.
Stop.
Check the fish?
Yep. Mm-hmm. I want you to look at the fish visually. What is it?
Skin is still not crispy, chef.
But look at the fish in general. Look at the size of the flakes underneath.
It's salmon.
It's salmon.
Chef Christina to the hot plate, please. This is salmon, not char. I need two char, please.
I'll be right behind. Give me 3.5 minutes, chef.
Despite not catching the salmon, Ashley is now in full control of the kitchen.
How long on that char?
2 minutes, chef.
Come on, you need to move quick.
Good, send it, please.
And entrees continue to move out quickly to the dining room.
All right, guys, let's dig in.
Last 3 tables, guys.
Yes, chef. Kristen, you have Wellington's crusty.
Slicing Wellies.
Tonight's dinner service, we were just killing it. This is exactly how this service should be.
Good. Let's go. Service, please.
Thank you.
I'm ready to walk on New York's
I think everyone was a little out of their element in the past, but we finished strong.
Yeah, the char is really good.
The char is really good.
It's kind of crispy. Yeah. I like it.
Delicious. I think it's kind of done to perfection.
We're going to order another one. These are unbelievable.
Ladies, come with me, please. Quickly. Tough one, but well done.
Thank you, Chef.
I'm going to ask you to do something that is very difficult, but very important. I want you to think about everything that has happened in Hell's Kitchen since the day you walked in, your first service. The ups, the downs, your strengths and weaknesses, and think of the one individual that should not be in the finale.
Yeah, Chef.
You got a lot to discuss. Head to the patio.
Yeah, Chef.
Great job.
I'm nervous going into elimination. Like, who doesn't deserve to be here? I mean, we all deserve to be here. I want to be in the finale.
I want to be in the finale too.
I feel like I've kept my mental state, my composure throughout this whole thing, and I've done nothing but build strength. This has been an amazing journey.
I pushed myself harder than I ever thought I even could, and I'm a leader. I am a strong leader. I know that.
I agree that you can be a leader, but I can't say there's any service or any one challenge that I can pinpoint or remember you like being leader or during prep, you being leader.
That is a really good point.
I know for a fact that I am, you know, a leader that Chef is looking for, so Ariel, you can go yourself. We need to think about every single thing that's happened so far. You know what I mean? Ariel, you have an attitude with everyone. I like to respect people.
I do agree with that.
I didn't talk back today. Like, I'm not a disrespectful person. Like, I haven't disrespected anybody in this competition.
I really kind of want to battle against Kristen in the finale.
So do I. I'm feeling pretty safe right now. It really all comes down to Ashley and Ariel, and having equal competition is all I want at the end of the day. We're all hungry for it,
for sure.
Proving that.
But I'm not going down without a fight.
None of us should.
First of all, you are definitely, without a shadow of doubt, deserving of being the final three, let me tell you that. But the big question tonight is, who deserves to be in the final two? Ariel.
Chef.
Why do you think you deserve to be in the Hell's Kitchen final?
Because I've pushed myself, I've learned a lot about my leadership skills, I have learned to be humble, I've learned to respect my craft here at Hell's Kitchen, and would be thrilled to showcase what I've learned in the finale.
Ashley.
I am focused and I'm driven, and I have grown tenfold since I've been here. I have pushed myself to my absolute limits, and it would be an honor to be in the finale. It's a dream of mine, so I know that I can do it.
Kristen.
Chef, I came into this competition with humility, focus, determination, and as I got stronger, I stayed consistent. I raised the bar for myself and for the chefs around me. I want the opportunity to bring that energy to BLT and drive that team to success.
Ashley, let me ask you this. Who doesn't belong in the Hell's Kitchen final?
I believe that Ariel doesn't belong in the final, Chef.
Why?
I feel that her personality may clash with a lot of people. She's sometimes disrespectful to leadership, and I feel that that is a hindrance.
Ariel.
Chef, I think Ashley doesn't belong in the finale because she overthinks a lot of things. She doubts herself sometimes and doesn't have the drive to be a head chef.
Kristen.
I believe it's Ashley that does not belong in the finale, Chef. Ashley wears her heart on her sleeve, and it can be a sign of weakness. Ashley is a huge overthinker, and I find overthinking can spread like a disease trying to lead a team.
It's time now to reveal who will be battling it out in the Hell's Kitchen final. The first person advancing to the Hell's Kitchen final is... Kristen. Congratulations.
Thank you, well Chef. Done. I'm soaring right now. So excited. Now I get to run my brigade in the most badass way possible on Hell's Kitchen.
Ashley, Ariel. This is one of the most difficult decisions I've ever had. The person who will be joining Kristen in the final is... The person who will be joining Kristen in the final is... Ariel.
Crazy!
Congratulations.
Thank you so much, Chef.
Ashley, step forward, please. Young lady, don't be upset. Here's why. You were born to cook, and I refuse to take your jacket. Because there was so little separating you from the finale, it was that tight.
Thank you, Chef.
Come here. Come on. Don't be upset.
Hey.
Well done. Head up high. Good night.
I did not come to Hell's Kitchen to walk through that door. I came to Hell's Kitchen to walk through the big door. The door to my future.
Where'd you work?
My family owns a couple of restaurants in Orlando.
Wow, mom and dad have got restaurants.
Two dads. Dad number one, dad number two. This has been a wild journey. Sorry, no. No.
Are you gonna vomit?
And it's been the hardest thing I've ever done.
You've checked out, right?
You know what I should be doing? Breaking your face right now.
Nobody should be talked to that way. I would never disrespect somebody like that. But I made it very far.
Ashley, congratulations.
Thank you, Chef. I'm proud of myself. After working with my dads for 8 years, I have done this entire competition completely on my own.
Those New York strips are cooked perfectly.
Thank you, Chef. I've done it with my own talent.
The dish of the day belongs to Ashley. Well done. Red team wins.
And I learned that I am one tough bitch.
3.5 minutes out.
Get it to me quicker, 2.5. Winning Hell's Kitchen.